Welcome to another quick stock analysis, and today I'm going to be looking at PayPal. In case you didn't know PayPal is my personal preferred method of payment. I pretty much try and pay everyone. If I buy something off Facebook Marketplace or eBay, or you know, if I'm doing any private transaction, I'll be doing it from PayPal, or I'll at least try and suggest PayPal to whoever I'm doing it with. Me personally, I've even got my Amex card linked up to PayPal, so everything that I do wherever I can is done through PayPal, so this is a big business for me. PayPal is a very popular company at the moment, PE ratio of 65, a PEG ratio of 23, and a normal growth rate, an estimated earnings growth rate of 23.86. So this company is growing, not only double digits, but it's growing in the 20s, 23 to 25. That's very, very good, high growth company. I'm not usually very good at high growth companies, but this is definitely one I can see a lot of promise in. As you can see from the graph, the share price has spiked in 2019, 2020 through the pandemic. So there might be a little bit of exuberance there. Well, a PE of 65 definitely shows the exuberance, but it doesn't necessarily mean that this company is uninvestable at this moment. There could possibly be something in there that could be investable. Let's take a look. Taking a look at PayPal's current ratio, we've currently got a current ratio of 1.2, which is very close to the mark. This company should be doing a lot better than that, in my opinion. I didn't know this. PayPal does seem to live on the edge. You would expect PayPal to be a bit better than this because of how much cash it's got flowing through its company. It's not a bad thing though. It's still covering its short-term earnings. It can still survive. There's no risk of it going bankrupt anytime soon. So this is perfectly okay. I'd love to just see it more in the twos. I really did expect PayPal to have a much higher current ratio, if I'm honest. Shares outstanding is surprising to me because PayPal is actually paying down shares, which is crazy. I would have thought this thing would be issuing like mad, but nope, declining outstanding shares by 0.7. I didn't know PayPal had a share buyback program. That's very, very positive. Year-on-year revenue growth is perfect, 18% a year. 5 years is still on the 18%, so this company is still growing very rapidly. Excellent stuff to see there. And what's really important about these new high growth companies is that they are actually profitable as well. A lot of these new exciting high growth companies are not profitable, but PayPal is definitely one of the big profitable companies. Growing at 18% over the past 8 years, past 5 year growth is closer to 19%. Excellent stuff. Debt has been growing with PayPal. Over the past year, it's gone up to $9 billion in debt. That's quite a lot. Not entirely sure why it would need to do that, but I guess it's in a similar boat to Visa, where cross-border payments were pretty low this year. So even though PayPal has quite a good hold on the online space, a lot of people weren't traveling, so there might not have been a lot of cross-border payments. Tourism might have been down, so they might have lost, and therefore they had to take on a little bit of debt. This company is also growing and acquiring all the time. Sorry, I don't know a lot about the qualitative data, but it's definitely something to consider. If this company is so profitable, it's got such good revenues, and it's paying down shares, why is it taking on so much debt in 2020? It's just something that you would need to look at going forward into the qualitative data. It doesn't quite match up there for me. Especially when free cash flow generation is so high and growing so well. Free cash flow is growing at 29.9% per year, and it's currently sitting at $4.5 billion. So its free cash flow just in 1 year is actually covering all of its debt. So that's a good thing. I just don't know why it's growing its debt and why it needs to grow its debt. I assume PayPal's got a lot of risk to Bitcoin at the moment, but that shouldn't really affect much here. That should really only affect the profits going on. In fact, what would be very fun again would be to see the net profit margin of PayPal and see how it's growing. A net profit margin of 50%. This is Visa level profit margin. This is really, really good. You can see how PayPal is very similarly following Visa's model, following JP Morgan's model, and then obviously Square is going to be one of those ones as well. So this is a huge profit margin. This is very, very good. And they're actually generating a higher profit margin every single year, going up from 45% all the way now to 55%, growing at 2.6% a year. That's really, really good. And you can see why PayPal now has such a high share price in comparison to its earnings. You can see why people are willing to pay such a high premium for PayPal right now. going forward, we do see that analysts really do think that PayPal is going to do very well going forward. There's a 16% reduction in cash flow in 2019. I don't know why. I think that's something to do with eBay, but I'm not entirely sure. But bang, 2020, 29% growth. 2021 expected 28% growth, and 2022 expected 23%. This is free cash flow growth. Going forward into 2023, which is probably a bit far ahead to be honest, 54% cash flow growth is just absolutely ridiculous. We would need to see why analysts really think that that is reasonable. PayPal is well covered by analysts with 48 in 2021, 48 in 2022, and 28 in 2023. That's a lot of analysts looking at PayPal right now. And on average, next year, the analysts think that PayPal will grow by 17%. And 2022, they'll grow by another 26%. And in 2023, another 24%. So this is good, solid earnings growth right here. This is great stuff. However, it should be obvious to everyone that this price is significantly over its earnings. And we need to figure out if this is a reasonable price to pay for PayPal right now. So currently in this forecast graph, I've got a mix of what the analysts think is going to happen going up to 2023. And then we've got a continuous growth rate of 20%, 22%, and 22%. This is quite a significant continuous growth rate, but I'm happy to put this on this for a company that is growing considerably. I'm very happy to put in a best case scenario that's indicated by the analysts and by historical growth as well. So in our best case scenario, and I'm putting it at a PE because I don't think these companies are going to stay at PEs of 65, 70, 1000. I don't think that's going to happen. So I'm going to hit it with a very generous PE of 40. And considering the PE of 40 at a growth rate of around 25% year on year, and you can see in my personal opinion, the best case scenario for PayPal right now over the next 5 years is a final finishing price of $511. That's up from around a $250 mark, which it's at right now. That's a capital appreciation of 92% and a total annual return of 12% year on year. That's a very, very good return. That's an extremely good return. Okay, so let's bring it back down to earth a bit and try and consider it in a normal scenario, not where we're in this exuberant state of the S&P 500. That situation, that best case scenario, will be the Jamie Dimon kind of scenario where we're kind of thinking that there's going to be a flood of money into the market over the next 3 years and there's going to be a bit of a boom. I think that's very, very possible. So it is very possible that PayPal can satisfy these analyst estimates. It's very possible that can happen. However, this is certainly priced almost to perfection right now, and there's not a lot of room for wiggle. If we put it back down to a reasonable PE ratio of, and I'm going to be generous again, of 27. Now that is still a very high terminal multiple for a growth company, but we can be very generous in these exuberant times. In fact, let's keep it to a very solid 25 PE just for the normal case scenario. And I'm just going to reduce the growth rate very slightly down to 18%. And what we have here now is a company that is quite highly priced to perfection. We are showing that this company is priced very, very fairly, in my opinion. This company in 2026 will have a final price of $299. That's a capital appreciation of 12%, so the chance of losing money on PayPal right now is actually quite low, but it is only a 2.08% return year on year, so you're not looking to beat the market right now. But this is in a sort of normal case scenario. This is something that you could probably expect from PayPal if the unexpected continues to happen considerably for the next couple of years. Then PayPal might continue just to trade at a PE of 65 for like 5 years. If you're getting that, you're getting some serious return there. But let's not forget that PayPal is in a very highly competitive market. You've got JP Morgan moving in, you've got Square, you've still got a lot of different banks that all want their slice of the pie. Regulation is being pushed for on these new fintech companies. Then maybe their growth rate does slow to about 18%. If it slows down to this 15% and only trades at a PE of 20, and these are still quite high valuations, these are still like serious growth numbers, these are still serious PE ratios. A final price in 2026 will be $227. That's a loss of 14.5%, almost 15%, with a total annual return of minus 2.74%. Now, the truth in this matter is that not a lot has to go wrong for PayPal in order to see just a drop to 15% growth. And that's a lot. 15% growth is a lot. It's just if it doesn't get it perfect in 2025 and 2026, it could just see that little bit of slowdown in growth. If it does see that little slowdown in growth, then it could be quite disastrous because of the current prices that we're paying. So the margin of safety here isn't brilliant, but it is a company that I really like, and it is a company that does have the possibility of growing a lot as it goes forward. A PE of 30, which isn't unreasonable, at a growth rate of 20%, which is kind of what it's growing at right now, that'll give you almost 40% return over the next 5 years. That's pretty good. Over the next 10 years, that will start to give you that 6 to 8% return to beat the market. As much as I really, really do like this company, I do like where its growth is going, I do think it's overvalued at the moment. Before I could buy this company, I'd have to see it at more like 170, 180 for me to start getting that 10%, 11% year-on-year return. However, this company has excellent revenue growth, its profit margin is absolutely massive, and it's got great free cash flow growth coming as well. This company is no longer that startup company that we all know it as. This company is definitely maturing, and this exponential growth phase that it's about to probably come to the end of, and it's probably going to start to really smooth out its growth. It's still going to have massive growth, it's just not going to be as exponential as it was before. I do think this company is exceptional, it's just so overpriced right now. Thank you very much for watching, guys, and if you enjoyed this video, please feel free to like, subscribe, and invest.